Hi guys, welcome to another chapter, another meetup of Null Delhi and Oasis Delhi. So today with us we have Ashwini, who will be speaking about report writing. Personally, for me, this is one of the most important part of any cybersecurity part, which we do all the time. This is the most ignored part, and I believe we should be really be focusing upon this thing. So I'll just pull up Ashwini. Hi Ashwini.
Hi Pratul, first of all, thank you so much for giving me this opportunity.
You're most welcome. It is our pleasure that you are speaking upon such an important topic, and it should be people should really know about this topic, and they should really gather very much tips about from this webinar.
Yes, that's the whole objective, behind this webinar. See, our field is a very, it deals with the security critical stuff. So
Yeah.
report writing is our end day deliverable. It has to be perfect. And I hope after the webinar, we'll all be convinced enough that yes, apart from certifications, technical certifications, report writing is also important and we should invest some time in it as well.
Exactly. So guys, who are there in this session? Hi everyone who have just joined the comment section as well. So I hope this will be a very nice session for you as well. So yeah, Ashwini, you can now start with the presentation. I have popped it on the screen. All the best.
Okay, thank you. Thank you, Pratul.
Yeah, bye.
Bye. Okay, so first of all, again, thank you, Null Delhi, for giving me this opportunity. And thank you, everyone, for attending. I know it's a Sunday and all that, but even the communities are doing this for us. So yes, we should participate. And participation also encourages speakers to come up with new topics and discuss about it. So yes, today I'm going to talk about that area of cybersecurity, which is important, but at the same time, something that is not widely discussed. So why is that? Aren't our end-day deliverables reports? Now, if you think about any field from cybersecurity, be it assessment, forensics, even our SOC or compliance, everything is dependent on reports, correct? What are we anyway? What is the purpose behind reports from these domains? Observations, we are presenting our observations, so reports are important. Now forget about the final reports, think about notes, investigation notes. Sometimes while testing, we make notes. So even these notes are nothing but writings. So these notes are important because tomorrow what will happen is people may refer to our notes and continue their investigation. So it is important that we communicate properly. Communication skills, see, understand that when we say communication skills, it is nothing but speaking and writing, all right?
Ashwini, we are unable to hear you. No, we cannot hear you. There seems to be some issue. Yes, your mic isn't connected, it seems. Yeah, hi guys. We are looking into this issue. Just give me a couple of minutes. For me, it's coming. Your mic isn't connected. No. So guys, till she comments upon her, like, let her just work upon the mic, which she is doing right now. Just give us a couple of minutes and we will be doing. Ashwini, we are unable to hear you. No, we are not unable to hear you. Can you have a look into the mute button as well? Like, if it is, if you're not on mute or like. Yeah, it seems we have some problem. We are just looking into the issue, guys. So just give me a couple of minutes. Ashwini, just try rejoining the session. So, sorry for this interruption. She is just rejoining the session. So no worries in that. So I believe many of us will have been involved in some aspect of report writing or the other in some part of the job. And I know it's a very boring thing and people do not prefer to write reports in a good fashion and in a good manner. Since being in the security domain for a way too long period, I can personally say it from my experience that yes, it is a boring part. It is a boring part of the job, but yes, it is a most important part because you need to present out your vulnerabilities, especially for the bug bounty, especially for all the people who are there in a professional domain, in all those IT people. Yes, it is important. And yes, we do we should really focus upon this aspect as well. So just give us, I'm sorry for the delay. Hi Adarsh, hi Danish, hi Ashutosh. I have told her to rejoin the session. Just give us. Ashwini?
Hello.
Yes, you are there.
Okay. Actually, I joined, I think, 2-3 minutes back. Still, it wasn't showing. It's now they are showing that you're in the show. Anyway, finally. So, am I audible? Hello.
Yes, you are audible. I'm just looking at the comments right now. So, yes, you are audible right now. You can share your screen.
Okay. Okay, so is my screen visible now?
No, not right now.
Okay.
See, on the down, you will see the option of sharing the screen that you will see three screens. One is mine, one is yours, and one is your computer screen. On
Correct. So I did
StreamYard.
this share screen and PPT. Can you see now?
No, I can't.
Now?
Yes.
Okay. But why is it taking time? Because even when I joined, it was
See,
showing me a little late, maybe.
there will be a lag. There will be some lag. I know it is a little great for you, but yeah, there is some gap. So no worries in that. You can just start off again. Like, because I guess many of the people, they have been saying like, you were on mute. I was trying to do it from my end as well. So yeah, you can start.
Okay, yeah, see, this is my first time live, so maybe a
No
little bit of
worries.
nervousness combined with technical criticalities.
Yeah, no worries. See, I guess, and I believe live session, these are happening for the first time after the lockdown. We have only seen and heard about these in the webinars and all, which we get invites from these
Correct.
cooperatives.
Correct.
So, yeah,
Okay,
and others say it might be a network issue. So, I'll just go into the backdrop. Actually, again, there's a problem, I guess. No. You can restart StreamYard. No, we can't hear you. No. Yes, I guess we will be switching to Zoom. Yeah, Danish, we will be switching, but I just hope let us troubleshoot this issue now. For now, just give us a couple of minutes, or if this doesn't work out, then we'll switch to Zoom. Just give us a couple of minutes. Actually, I guess there seems to be some problem with the hardware, like the mic, because we heard some thumping sounds. Yes, we can hear you.
Yeah, so I think this will work without headphones, directly on loudspeaker. So
Yeah.
am I audible now?
I guess, yeah, you are audible to me. I guess to the people as well, you will be audible. You can share your screen. You are audible right now. The issue with screen share, whenever you share screen, you need to allow audio. Okay. You can share your screen now, actually.
Can you see my screen now?
Yes, we can see a screen.
All right. So hopefully this works.
Yes.
Hopefully.
Yes, you can go ahead now.
Okay. So I'll again repeat the same thing. Think about the number of times you were told to work upon your writing and improve on it. So the answer to that is nothing but the current scenario of report writing in cybersecurity. All right. So what I feel is report writing is most of the times considered as secondary or something that is an additional skill set and not a primary. Okay, it can't be a primary skill set. If I want to join forensics, obviously forensics relevant certifications will be important. But then have we thought, without writing or without speaking, without communication skills, how will you communicate your knowledge? So if report writing is not secondary, it is not even primary, then what is it? So one thing I want to conclude here before we begin is that it is an equivalent. This is one thing all of us should remember. If we are doing OSCP, CEH, CHFI, we should ensure we are also learning how to communicate about those critical findings, how to write a proper, formally correct report. Now that the stage has been set, and if everyone is on the same page, let us continue ahead and let's see what we can do towards working on it. And rest assured, don't think that we'll have to do English majors or something like that. After this webinar, at least there'll be few points that you can immediately work from tomorrow. Ensure you write or make a checklist of it. All right, so quickly, who am I? My name is Ashwini Varadkar. Obviously, you must be knowing that. And rest of the details to save time, just go through it. One important point, yes, special off towards reporting as well as report reviews. When I review a report, I ensure that we deliver the best quality report. At the same time, we also, have conversations with consultants who are writing and tell them how they can improve and everything. So for this, report writing is my special area of interest. Okay, so what is a report? See, sometimes it is important that you go back to the roots of a term to understand it better. Now, report is derived from the Latin word of reporter. Re means back and porter means to carry, portability, return, reuse. So a report is basically a description of an event carried back to someone who was not on the scene. So if you are taking this description to people who are absent during the testing or during the investigation, you have to ensure that your report is correct, complete. It is accurate and also reliable, that you can depend on it. So that's how traditionally the definition of report was. Now, obviously today, due to advent of technology, criticality of various things, chaining of attacks, attack vectors, hardware criticalities, report writing has become a challenge, but reports are valuable. So here today, report represents information in structured format. It is a short and concise document, is purposeful and has an audience. Now, short and concise, we all understand. Purposeful and audience. Purposeful in cybersecurity, can anybody tell me what could be the purpose? See, this cybersecurity domain has many subdomains, but we can summarize the purpose of every subdomain in one word. Think about it. What are we doing anyways? We are talking about observations, issues, findings, isn't it? Even if we are investigating a scene, we are reporting what we observed. Similarly with penetration testing, we observed that. XYZ organization observed that. So our purpose is noting down the observations. And audience. Audience in cybersecurity is varied. One report, there are chances that a lot of people from different categories will read your report. First, your fellow pen testers, suppose any tester from your group wants to refer to that report, senior management from the client team. Then we have our developers who will do the fixing. Suppose your client is going through an audit, compliance people will refer to your report. So in short, you need to ensure that your report is not too detailed, at the same time, not less detailed, because the audience is varied. And what do you think now that we have varied audience, how should a report be basically so that everyone understands? What is it that aisa kya hai ki sabko hi samajh mein aayega? Kab? When a report is simple, written in an absolutely simple manner, anybody can understand. So that is what we are trying to achieve, effective report writing. So now that we know report, let me make a conclusion. Cybersecurity and reports, these are inseparables. So understand that going ahead, even you will want to level up, correct? So how will you do that? Improve on your report writing. If you feel okay, now I know everything or that I have done enough of learning, you can try your hands on improving on report writing. Try to create templates. try to provide valuable input when you are reviewing reports. Now, sometimes you will come across that a person understands CSRF completely properly, but then he's not able to reproduce it. Then you can tell them, okay, first thing you tell them the user accounts that were provided, the user account you used to sign in. Tell them about the HTML code, POC. Tell them what will the code do. You know, stepwise you can go about it because these are inseparables now. And you can level up. This is one domain where you can invest time. SOC team, we have log monitoring alerts, we have advisories, assessment, pen test reports, forensics, again, investigation notes, case studies, compromise assessment reports, compliance, audit reports. So in short, this is inseparable. If you are associated with cybersecurity field, you will be associated with reports. All right. Now, the reality check. How did I realize that there is a gap? There are many other people who are working towards, you know, report reviews and how to improve this in our country. So I will tell you about me how I realized that there is a gap and that it needs to be addressed. At some point of time, you will be a leader, team leader. You may become a technical reviewer or a dedicated reviewer, ensuring technical accuracy and language related checks. You will be a project manager. Now, these people, at some point of time, the report will definitely reach to these people. If he's your leader, project leader, he will see the report. Reviewer, he's a dedicated reviewer, so obviously he has to see. Project manager, he will be the one who will submit the final report. Again, he will see. So after a survey, internally, it was realized that, okay, there is a gap. If we can't understand the attack, if we are not able to recreate, if the mitigations are too generic, and suppose the finding is that XYZ is missing, and if you are providing the same line in the remediation, XYZ is missing, that is not a remediation. You should give something more relevant, something more detailed. So internally, this is how in our journey, via our experience, it was realized that there is a gap. Other ways in which you can realize this: external rejections. Client will send you back the report. This happens a lot. This happens. They will give you comments, make this and this change. So does this look good? Social media posts. Many enthusiasts, bug bounty enthusiasts, they post POC and everything on Twitter. Okay, if you are maintaining security, fine. But people are posting all this on WhatsApp stories also. So my point is, mask relevant details. Practice what you preach. You're a security person. Once I told a guy, do masking and then upload. Even after masking, via some titles, email subject, it was still clear ki who is the client. So you need to be alert. What is all this? This is a reality check. Again, the most important part is not talked about a lot. These gaps are not discussed. People take it really lightly. What has happened is a company can even fire you if wrong information is disclosed, if very critical information, one client's information is reached to other client. These are not good things. Even IP addresses, URLs, you need to be careful while copying. If you are referring to someone else's report, if you are new in a company, make damn sure you're copying correctly. So this is a reality check. Okay, now need for effective writing. Now let me tell you these two points. I personally feel these are very important. And after this, many people will invest time in report writing. There are people who are just not passionate towards writing. It's fine. Even I wasn't passionate. But then some people have opinion that why can't we automate writing? Let's have a tool in place. Let tool do everything. But think about it, your validation steps, your proof of concept cannot be automated. That is situation environment dependent, correct? How much will you automate? End of the day, you have to write something. Now, this also reminds me of our observations with 00 score. That is informational findings, best practices. We do give in our report, right? You can communicate a lot via your reports. That, theek hai, these are the findings, but I realize that two-factor authentication is missing. Though there is no direct impact, I want to give this as an informational finding. So can you, how much will you automate all this best practices, informational? This is from your mind. You are thinking it on the fly. So you have to write. First objective, reputation. Now misspellings, spelling mistakes, incoherent sentences, meaning sentences from which meaning cannot be derived, grammatical mistakes, all this detract from the professionalism of a report, leading readers to be doubtful of your output, even if it is completely accurate. Now to best understand this, think of a phishing email. Think of a legitimate email. You get an email from a bank, sender, receiver, everything is perfect, signature perfect. But then there are spelling mistakes in the message body, email message body. What will your immediate response be? You'll be like, okay, this looks fake. Something is there. I have to check. I'll call customer care. Correct? So if you have a report, your client logo, your company logo, your name, and there are so many mistakes, even the criticality of the finding will be doubted by the client. So this is how it is. And you will also do the same thing. So the number one objective is reputation, because your name is in the report. Client's name is there. Company name is there. Second point is consulting. Now people who think report writing should be automated, you are a consultant. If you are a consultant, speaking, writing, communication, consulting is your job role. So there is no running away from it. There is no denying. If you cannot communicate the finding, or if you can't justify the criticality of a finding, your knowledge will be limited to you. So these are top two reasons. Being a consultant, you have to get into it. Secondly, reputation or a good impression. Now the common mistakes. These mistakes are not very talked about. Communicating someone else's output, someone else got that issue, but you are writing about it. Many mistakes are observed here. For one person, two images would be perfect for the POC. When I am writing it, I'll be like, nope, this is missing, that is missing. I may end up making mistakes. I don't know that person's an exact environment. It may so happen that due to human error, he may miss out giving some details to me. So all this happens. If it is your finding, when you give the report to him to write, just give proper pointers, proper POC to him. We cannot be dependent that, okay, finding name bata diya, he will do it. Now think about outdated software related finding. You told him, I've got this finding, critical, write about it. Now he may wonder, okay, why is this critical? There are no public exploits. So such kind of confusion may arise, and this will be reflected in reports. Second is vague sentences, sentences from which meaning cannot be derived. Now findings like IDOR, CSRF can get really critical at one point. So you end up writing sentences from which a reader cannot make the attack. He cannot reproduce or recreate the attack in his mind. So this needs to be addressed. Third is image related issues. You know what? Images should be such that just by looking at the images, IDOR, before, after, modification, then what is the response? Correct. Just by images also, people should be able to make sense out of it. Again, image, relevant masking, relevant highlights. If we sit and talk about it, image related, there are many points. So basically, these are the common mistakes which are observed. Next, I'm going to tell you about common concerns. First is unable to lead people through the content in a structured way. They should get the information that they want quickly and easily. Now, I think an organization and an employee should share the responsibilities. Unable to lead people through the content in a structured way. So somewhere this is talking about templates, a person who's accountable, someone who will solve our queries, someone to whom we can reach out. So these things are such that a company can keep ready for us a good template so that half our job is done there. And there are sections like executive summary. We have a bibliography or a different section for references, all the references listed together. So these things can be defined so that half our job will be done there. The second point, confusion about writing style, what to include, the language to use, etc. Now this is individual thing. The pointers that we'll see ahead, if you make a list of it, that will help you with the confusion and you'll be sorted. even the length of the document, what to write, how much to write. This is upon individual. You can read, there are many courses on business email writing, report writing. So if you just invest some time in it, gradually by writing, you'll get there. Now, very important, what is effective? Effective meaning someone should get quality output from it. He should get information from. So according to me, there are two important things, rules and concept. Concept is nothing but our storytelling. Now, if your concept is not clear, you cannot write it correctly, and the other person, the reader, will not be able to deduce or derive any meaning from it. Storytelling is important because when you talk about compromise or you want to explain chaining of attacks, this is nothing but story. So concept is number one important. Clarity, message has to be reached. Next is rules. Now here we are talking about report writing, a very formal thing. Without rules, you can't use internet slang languages. You cannot use contractions. There are many things. You know what? Even if your concept is clear, you may get your report back because you have used contractions or, you know, randomly capital words. So effective report is the one that is formally correct. And message is also derived. Okay, so simply two things you can remember. Now, before we check on the things that are to be kept in mind, understand what all comes under formal writing. Academic research papers, business presentations, you can apply the pointers that we'll discuss in these. Emails and memorandums, business reports, and any type of official correspondence. So all this comes under formal writing. Now, sometimes PPTs or, you know, blogs, those can be informal. It depends upon creativity. If you want to, you know, reach out to people, you want cool stuff. So that is fine. But then with clients and everything, you need to stick to the rules of formal writing. I just mentioned about contractions. So a contracted word is a word that is nothing but a combination of two words. Should plus not. These are two words. Shouldn't is its contracted word. Here, a letter has been skipped and it has been replaced with an apostrophe. So when I say don't use contractions, you should not use words like shouldn't, won't, aren't, isn't. Write full, should not. Now, if you read about this, people have discussed that contractions till certain amount or in some situations, it is okay, but avoid it for formal reports. So my point is simply to avoid confusion. Let us avoid contracted words in report writing. This is one thing that you can add in your checklist. Simply use full words, no contractions. Okay, now here there is no right and wrong, but prefer your sentences in active voices. Now, active voices are short and direct. See this example, the analyst observed an excessive instance. Now in executive summary, in remediation, we don't need a big paragraphs. It is recommended that simple, 1 point, 2 point, second point, third point. These sentences can be in active voice. The analyst observed this. This was observed, this was not observed. Do this, do that, simple. The only place where I can see or think of where passive voices can be used is proof of concept. There you cannot be too direct. The analyst observed an excessive instance. We gave this payload. It will be more of an order then. So there, theek hai, a small paragraph is fine, supported by an image. But otherwise, the preferred tone is of active voice. And some of the places also, I'll tell you, recommendations can be pointers. In executive summary, in short, if you want to list weaknesses or limitations, or you want to list the findings and you want to describe the findings in one line for the senior management, active voices can be used here. So first point was avoid contractions. See, if you make this checklist, gradually you will start remembering these points. Now going ahead, remember consistency is the key. this was a rule. Here, there is nothing called as right and wrong, just preference, that active voice is preferred as per our observations. And passive voice you can use for proof of concepts. Now, from here, the choice is yours, but ensure consistency. Capitalize the important words in the title. There are two ways in which you can give titles. This first letter is capital everywhere, or this. First letter by default will always be capital no matter what, but see, rest lower cases. So if you give your first finding name as this, ensure the same format is maintained everywhere. Or if it is this, ensure this has been maintained everywhere. So consistency is the key. There is nothing called as right or wrong here. So which are the words written in lower cases? A and the. If you see in here, I will not be capital. Even, you know, tools like Microsoft Word, they will also help you with this. They'll give you a red line below. So you will know that, okay, this needs to be in lowercase. But as per me, if it is a title or a headline, then I will prefer this format. Now, again, the same rule applies to image captions. Image captions are also nothing but short titles, correct? So if the first image caption is like this in lower cases, stick to it and everything has to be same. Or if it is this, stick to it. But do not make a mix. Do not make a mix. Ensure consistency in your report. And how hard is that? You just have to make a decision that anytime I write a report, this is what I'm going to follow. Now, the next thing is capitalization in sentences. Similar to capitalization, random capitalization in titles, it is the same here. Now, if you see this example, URLs should not contain any sensitive information. S capital, I capital. It would have worked perfectly fine without those two terms being in capital. It looks good that we are highlighting key terms. But then if you are starting something like that, you have to achieve consistency. So if you can avoid, why not write it simply as given in the second pointer? Correct? Now, if the session token name was to be mentioned, then you will write it as it is. Suppose there's some ASP authentication cookie and they are writing it as ASP capital, net capital, and AUTH auth also capital. Then you will write it exactly because that is a keyword now. That is a name, how it has been defined. So in such cases, you will write it how it has been defined. But otherwise, I don't see any reason for making random capitalization in sentences. URL is an abbreviation, so this will always be in caps. Any abbreviation will be in caps. Capitalize proper nouns. Names, countries, cities is something we'll encounter a lot in our reports. Client location, data center location, branches, client name. So see this example. XYZ organization discovered multiple instances of weak physical security in sample organizations, Chicago data center. Now you might be wondering, why is X not capital? But XYZ organization is the official name of that organization and this is how it has been defined. So in that cases, you cannot make any change. So this will remain as it is. But otherwise, the first letter will be capital for regions, names, countries. Okay, now this is very important in our field. Software name. Now, as you can see, I'm sure a lot of relatable posts or type of thing must have happened with you. So JavaScript abbreviator as JS. So this is a correct way that it is written and not like this. jQuery and not this or this. Clickjacking, not this. So do one thing, just check how is SQL map written. How has the official site defined their name, SQL map? Check that once. So basically the point is, whenever you are writing about tools, attacks, software, the name has to be as it is on their official website. this also applies to attack names. Yes, Eternal Blue, Poodle is an abbreviation. CSRF is an abbreviation. Then we have Blue Keep, again B capital, K capital, Hard Bleed, H capital. I think B is not capital. So all these things you should check before, you know, writing. Even one point I would add here is that NMAP, N capital map. Normally, if we have to write, we'll write NMAP, N capital and map. But in terminal, it is NMAP, everything in lower cases. So don't get confused. What you write in terminal is different and maximum times in lower cases. But originally, how the official websites define them will be different. Now, some people have a list of tools separately in their report, a different section. So that time, again, this will be important. You cannot just write anything. You may go to their official website, check the exact format, write it, make it clickable so that, you know, clients can refer. That is optional. And that is why this is important. Software name has to be as it is. Now, suppose anybody misspells your name in a report, you won't like it, right? So keywords, terms which are defined has to be as it is.
I agree with you. Because many a times it happens, we tend to forget the difference between the command name and the software name. For example, you gave the command, you gave the example of NMAP right now, right?
Right.
So we do have, and many a time it has seen, like NMAP is just one of the example. The commands by which we write the names and the name of the vulnerability, it might be very different. The capitalization which you just mentioned, it will be different. Yeah.
Correct. And this also reminds me of our eyewitness tool. Now, suppose you are using that tool and you are writing using eyewitness. Just imagine the meaning also changes. So have we created the POC using eyewitness tool, or we have actually bought eyewitnesses to witness that attack? So in such cases, then you have to emphasize on that keyword. We are going to talk about that later. So these things are important. Yes, highlights and emphasis. So in technical fields, you may come across, you know, terms which are like, which have a different meaning in English language, but it is also a tool name, you know, like eyewitness. Then there are many such tools, you know. So in such cases, if you want to stress, if you want to really stress on the word, like even cookie, secure flag, you may say cookies are not secure. Some people may understand, okay, cookies are not secure, so encrypt them or do something about them. But here we are talking about the flag. So if you write the secure term in a single quote or double quote, the readers will understand, okay, we are emphasizing, we are trying to tell something else about it. So this is where the highlights and emphasis comes into picture. Make relevant highlights. Use single or double quotes to stress on a word, but ensure consistency. Now, suppose from start, if you have used a single quote, going ahead, don't use double quotes. Don't make a mix. This you have to keep in your mind, that consistency is the key. This is not at all acceptable that you are using different kind of emphasis or highlight format. If you have highlighted an important word in the beginning of a report using bold, stick to bold. Then don't change it to underline, because then people will wonder, okay, what was the definition of bold words and what is underlined words? Are underlined words very, very important and bold words not important? So these questions may arise. So take one style and stick to it throughout the report. Now, subtitles can be emphasized by using bold. Suppose in POC section, like example, username enumeration, suppose there are multiple instances of it. So you can write username enumeration, case one or instance one. Case one or instance one should be in bold or underlined or written in some other format, so that we know that, okay, username enumeration is a title, instances one, two are subtitles. So we understand about the divisions there. Similarly, under remediation, strong password policy, remediation, you will first talk about password rules, then you write 1, 2, 3, whatever the rules are, so and so length, special characters, etc. Then talk about passphrases, highlight the word passphrases, so that people know, okay, remediation, strong password, password, passphrases. So this is how it is easier for you to write and the readers to understand. Then sometimes you have to edit an existing report, retest, reassessments. So that time observe the template. If XYZ uses a single quote, go through the report once. If you observe a lot of single quotes are used, continue that with your write-up. Think about it that, okay, for me, the highlight and emphasis format has been defined and I will stick to it now. Consistency is important. If anybody has already started with single quotes and you are just adding on to it, you have to adjust to it then. Consistency needs to be achieved. Again, images. If we talk about just images and POCs, there is a lot more that can be said. So all images must be aligned in one specific way. Suppose you prefer left aligned, then ensure all the images are left aligned. Relevant masking must be done, your own host name, your own data. Many a times I even see game tabs open, different client emails are open. So this is not a very good sign. Relevant masking must be done. Or take screenshots properly. Try to hide the bookmarks or something, close the tabs, and then take proper screenshots. Images should be clear. Now sometimes people just print screen and the entire screen is there, but think about it, when you put it on a document, it will be compressed, and on 100% or max to max 100 to 10%, it will not be visible. So better take only the relevant area the first time itself. Don't think, okay, I've taken the entire screen, aage jaake I will take the relevant. You can do that, but then don't forget about it. Due to lack of time or due to a rush, don't put the entire thing. It has to be comfortably readable. The person should not zoom in, zoom out every time. Apart from this, for images, there are many things. Sometimes, POC is also important. For which finding, what POC you are taking. Now, suppose if you want to talk about secure and HTTP only flags, in that case, there are other add-on browser plugins also from which you can get a better, clear, small POC. So that time, maybe burp is not needed. Request response entirely the big thing. So think about like that. Think about this like that also. See from which tool you'll get a better POC. Even Linux terminal is kind of transparent. So sometimes there are folders in the backend which are visible. So these points must be noted and remembered whenever you are taking a screenshot. All right. So what is the conclusion from all of this? The 2 points for effective report writing were content, that is storytelling, and rules. We discussed a lot about rules. So what about storytelling? So see, the storytelling part or the content part depends upon you. To improve your writing, you have to write. You can read, you can speak in English. See, even sometimes native English speakers also make mistakes while writing. So remember that your speaking has got absolutely nothing to do with writing. Write, get it reviewed, or get some feedback from your seniors or anybody that you want, and work on it. Don't invest a lot of time, and remember, it is an equal, not primary, not secondary. So work on it. Every time you learn a new attack, try to write, read, make sense out of it. Ask someone else to read. One thing that you can do is write down points. Suppose and or, so affected parameter. What change did you make? Then what did you do? Then what was the response? What was the original response because of which you came to know that something is wrong? So you can write pointers or 2-3 words and then frame sentences around it. Obviously, there are various tools. Even you can Google the simplest of things. Fixed synonym. Learn new words. Fixed antonym. Of course, why not? We have all the resources that are required. Ask for help. If there is any accountable person in your organization, you can talk to them. Share the responsibilities. Like I said, from an organization's perspective, a template is important. From an individual perspective, his own study and practice is important. There are many courses, apps, books, ebooks available. Courses, I cannot take the name, that is your own choice. You can check for those free courses, paid courses. Just look at the reviews and the summary. Business email writing is important. Report writing is important. So these points should be covered. Then we have apps. In Play Store, there are many apps. You know, you can play like a game. Fill in the blanks type. So your confusion regarding will be cleared. And this will hardly take two to three minutes level wise, like a game. So that is one thing that you can do. Books, ebooks, technical writing books. There are many books. You can Google. If you want me to provide some names, I can give it to you. I have made a note of some good books. And checklist, maintain a checklist. If you are to write a report, you should be knowing that this is what I will use for emphasis. This is what I will use for highlights. Sometimes for emphasis, you can use single quotes. You can highlight using bold. Consistency is the key. Consistency is important. So once or twice, you will have to refer to the checklist. Then you'll get a hang of it. Because you won't be changing that often, right? It's only one time that you have to decide, okay, when I am writing, single quote it is, bold it is, underline it is, that's it. It is not a very difficult task. I was not at all a good report writer. So if I can do this, you can do far better. So let us all learn, and via our reports and talks, share knowledge. So yes, this is all from me. Thank you for giving me this opportunity. And just see how this thank you appears. That is why font styles are important. Even with a smiley, it's looking so scary. So over to you, Pratul. If you have anything, please ask me.
Yeah, it is over. Thank you, Ashwini, for this session. I'm sure it will be a really helpful one for all the attendees. Because personally speaking, for me as well, I have been focusing on all the meets as well, that someone should at least give out a talk or a webinar on these, on the effective use of and how to write a report effectively. And thank you for doing that. So guys, if you don't know about Ashwini, she is the InfoSec Girls Mumbai chapter lead. She is based out of Mumbai. And she's also a volunteer for Mumbai, OWASP Mumbai as well. She has been an active community member. And thank you, Ashwini, for just reaching out, like helping the NAL Delhi and OWASP Delhi people and like sharing your experiences and your slides on this. Thank you.
Thank you. See, the pleasure is all mine. Thank you so much.
Yep. And for all, we will be sharing the slides, and the video will be available for the people who can just view it afterwards as well. So yes, it will be available. So yeah. Okay, Ashwini. Bye.
Bye. Thank you. Bye bye.
So guys, I guess that's it from our end for this week. We have been trying to just have a weekly session for all these webinars. We are still in talks with some speakers to have it from next week as well. So please, if you like this video, please share it and like share your comments so that just get enough motivation. So yeah, that's it for this week. Hope to see you soon. Stay healthy. Bye bye.